In this lesson, we'll be taking a look at higher order derivatives. Higher order derivatives refer to the second derivative, third derivative, fourth derivative, and so on. So we're familiar with the notation for the first derivative seen here, but now we need to become familiar with the higher order derivative notation as we see here for second derivative, here for third derivative, here for fourth derivative, and so on. In order to determine the second derivative of a function, we first find the derivative function and then find the derivative of the derivative function. And then for the third derivative, we find the derivative of the second derivative, and so on. In this video, we'll find the first through fourth derivative of the given function, and then we'll look at more examples in the next several videos. And to determine the following derivatives, we'll be applying the basic power rule stated here in red to each of these terms. So for the first derivative, we're going to multiply by 7 and then subtract 1 to get the new exponent. So that'll give us 14x to the 6th minus multiply by 3 and subtract 1, that'll be 9x squared plus 8 times the derivative of x, which is 1, so we have just plus 8, and the derivative of 2 is 0. So here's our first derivative, which should be review. But we need this to determine the second derivative, which is a derivative of the derivative. So now we'll find the derivative of the first derivative. So we'll multiply by 6, that'll be 84, and then subtract 1 from the exponent, that's going to be x to the 5th, minus, we'll multiply by 2 and subtract 1 to get the new exponent, that'll be minus 18x, and the derivative of 8 would be 0. So here's our second derivative. And now to determine the third derivative, we find the derivative of the second derivative. So we're going to multiply by 5 and then subtract 1 to get the new exponent. 84 times 5 is 420, so we have 420x to the 4th minus 18 times the derivative of x, which is equal to 1, so we have minus 18. So here's our third derivative. And then for the fourth derivative, we find the derivative of the third derivative. So we're going to multiply by 4 and then subtract 1 to get the new exponent. 420 times 4 is equal to 1,680x to the 3rd, and the derivative of 18 would be 0. So here's our fourth derivative. And one important thing to remember about these higher order derivatives is if we were asked to determine the fourth derivative of a given function, there's no real shortcuts. We would first need to determine the first derivative, second derivative, and then third derivative before we were able to determine the fourth derivative. And there are several applications for higher order derivatives, which we will be looking at in the near future. But for right now, we're just developing our skill for determining higher order derivatives. I hope this was helpful.